Okay, it's a long one. The Lord said to Moses, leave this place, you and the people you brought out of Egypt, and go to the land that I promised to give to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and to their descendants. I will send an angel to guide you, and I will drive out the Canaanites, the Amorites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. You are going to be rich and fertile land, but I will not go with you myself, because you are stubborn people, and I might destroy you on the way. When the people heard this, they began to mourn, and did not wear jewelry anymore. For the Lord had commanded Moses to say to them, you are a stubborn people. If I were to go with you, even for a moment, I will completely destroy you. Now take off your jewelry, and I will decide what to do with you. So after they left Mount Sinai, the people of Israel no longer wore jewelry. Whenever the people of Israel set up camp, Moses would take the sacred tent and put it up some distance away from the camp. It was called the tent of the Lord's presence. And anyone who wanted to consult the Lord would go out to eat. Whenever Moses went out there, the people would stand at the door of their tents and watch Moses until he enters it. After Moses had gone in, the pillar of cloud would come down and stay at the door of the tents. And the Lord would speak to Moses from the cloud. As soon as the people saw the pillar of cloud at the door of the tents, they would bow down. The Lord would speak with Moses face to face, just as a man speaks with a friend. Then Moses will return to the camp. But the young man who was his helper, Joshua, son of Nun, stayed in the tents. Moses said to the Lord, it is true that you have told me to lead these people to that land, but you did not tell me whom you would send with me. You have said that you know me well and are pleased with me. Now, if you are, tell me your plans so that I may serve you and continue to please you. Remember also that you have chosen this nation to be your own. The Lord said, I will go with you and I will give you victory. Can I hear you say amen?
Amen.
Moses replied, if you do not go with us, don't make us leave this place. How will anyone know that you are pleased with your people and with me if you do not go with us? Your presence with us will distinguish us from any other people on earth. The Lord said to Moses, I will do just as you have asked, because I know you very well and I am pleased with you. Then Moses requested, please let me see the dazzling light of your presence. Amen. Our topic this morning says, my presence will go with you and it shall be well with you. He says, my presence will go with you and I will give you rest. That's what some translations will say. Rest in biblical terms means victory, means triumph, means peace. So when the presence of God abides with you, you will have rest. You will have peace. You will have joy. Amen. The story was told of a very little boy who had gone to a supermarket with the parents.
And so while they were picking something, I don't know, many of you go to Spa or to Market Square. Market Square is not too big. Spa is very big, though not big, as compared to some places where you go. So this family went in to buy something, and while they were moving around, their little baby that was with them, a little boy, got lost inside the shopping mall. And then the parents didn't know. You know, sometimes when you go out with them, they run around. Before you know it, maybe they might follow one side and they get lost inside the place. And so the parents didn't know, and the boy now started looking for the parents. So but while he was looking for the parents, he went and stood at a particular position. Somebody came to him and said, "You are looking for your parents." He said, "Yes." He said, "Okay, come, let's look for them." He said, "No. I will not leave here to any other place except I locate where my parents are." That the only place he wants to be now is where his parents are. Because in the company of the parents, they had assurance. In the company of the parents, he was not lonely. In the company of the parents, he was not lost. But he was what? Secure. And so he stayed on. And so eventually the parents were able, I mean, he stepped out and stood in front of the place so that anyhow, whenever they come out, they will meet him there. And eventually the parents came out and they met him and they took him. And the boy was happy. This is exactly the experience of Moses today. But before this time, Moses had enjoyed the presence of God. You remember his experience at the burning bush in Exodus chapter 3, when he was leading the flock of the Pharaoh of Jacob. And then all of a sudden, on his way to near the foot of Mount Sinai, he saw the bush burning. And then he made a step, what was actually happening, only for him to discover that the bush was burning, but the grasses were not what? Consumed. And as he made to see further, he heard a voice that said to him, "Moses, Moses, do not come what? Near, for where you are standing is a holy ground." That was the experience of God's presence. And God's presence at that particular time was magnificent. It was awesome to behold fire flaming in the bush, but the greenery was seen the way it was. So he had met that. And then finally God gave him a command. "And by this very experience of yours, you will go to Egypt and tell Pharaoh, let my people do what? Go." And then he said, "How would this be? I am a stammerer. How can I accomplish this?" While he was busy complaining, the Lord said, "You have a brother. He will look, he's coming, he will go with you. He will be your mouthpiece, and you will lead." And then when he complained again, the Lord said to him, "What do you have in your hand?" He said, "A staff." The Lord said, throw it to the ground, and he did. And when he did, the staff turned into what? Snake. And then he was scared. The Lord said, "Pick it from the tail," and he did. And he turned back to his staff. And then the Lord said, "That is your instrument of war. And that is your instrument, that is your power. Use it." And then they headed for Egypt. They went to Egypt. Though he had a company, but there was a greater company that was with him, and that was the presence of God. And so when he got to Egypt and the journey began, and all the interactions with Pharaoh that culminated in the killing of the first sons in Egypt that made Pharaoh to let the Israelites go, he opened the door of freedom for them to leave. And they left, and it was a long journey. But you will remember, the Lord said to him that day, when this happens, the Israelites will make a sacrifice, and following from that sacrifice, the blood will be spilled. And with the blood spilled, then your departure begins. The missionaries departed. Now, on that journey, something happened. In Exodus chapter 32, when God had invited Moses up the mountain to behold his face, to behold his presence, and to be given the law that will guide the Israelites and the lands, he stayed too long. He stayed about 40 days and 40 nights, as scripture says. Now, during that moment, God led him through a period of encounter with him. He enjoyed God's glory. The Shekinah glory will always come upon the mountain. The dew of heaven will always come upon the mountain. The cloud of God will always come upon the mountain. And he interacted with God face to face. So Moses knew what he enjoyed when you talk about God's presence with you. And so that was why, when in Exodus chapter 3, following from the sin of the people of Israel, because in chapter 32, the Israelites, when they lost patience with Moses and also with God, they told Aaron to make them a molten what? God. Which he did and brought to them. And then they said, this is the God who brought you out of Egypt. An insult to God. Disobedience at work. And Moses, God reminded Moses, go down quick. The people you brought are apostatized. They have departed from the way I demanded of them. And then Moses rushed down from the mountain in anger. And while he was running down, he got seeing what the people were doing, out of anger, he broke the tablets of the law that was given to him. And he berated the people for their acting. Amen. And thereafter, he went into prayer. He was angry, but yet he went into prayer. And he said, God, please forgive them. Amen. If it is some of us now, we pray that the person should die. Or that God should kill the people so that we can possess everything. You know, there are people like that. Amen. But he did not do that. He interceded on behalf of the people. And God listened to him. When that happened, the Lord then in chapter 33, the Lord did something in it. The Lord said, Moses, I have heard your prayer and I've heard your request. I forgive them. But now, take them out of this place. Take them out of their comfort zone. They have been here for too long. They have been too comfortable here. And that is why it seems they are losing their sense. Let them go and possess the land that I have promised to their ancestors. Because one, God is a faithful God. When he makes a promise, he keeps his word. Promise. God did not want it to seem like he was not keeping his promise. And so he said, leave this place. But though you did, I will send my angel ahead of you. Praise the Lord. I will send my angel ahead of you. I pray that God's angel will be ahead of you. I pray that your angel will always be ahead of you. I pray that your angel will always make the way for you. Because the Lord says he will make the way for you and he will fight for you. So that wherever you enter, nobody will stop you. Nobody will challenge you. Nobody will confront you. He says, anybody that confronts you, my angel will do what? Confront him. He said that to him. But Moses was not satisfied. Carter, the angel of God, was going to fight for them. But Moses was not satisfied. Moses said, no, Lord, that is not enough. You cannot fail to be in our midst. In the caravan that was carrying and leading the Israelites, that God cannot fail to be in their midst. Yes, your angel will fight, your angel will make the way, but there is a difference of you being in our midst. You will remember when they fought with the Philistines, when they were torn against the Israelites, they went and brought the Ark of the Covenant into the battlefield, and the Ark was captured. the presence of God in their midst changes the tone and the story and of the movements. And so they said, no. Moses said, no. If you are not going with us, don't even dare tell me to lead them out here.
Amen.
I like that. When he said that to God, you know what? There is this boldness that comes to you when you experience God. You now speak to him like your words. You talk to him like your father. You talk to him like your friend. You talk to him like somebody you are feeling. When you experience God, you cannot but interact with him that way. And that the experience of God elicits faith, power, confidence, boldness, and courage. And that was what Moses was doing. He said, look, you are joking. God, you told God, you are what? Have you ever told someone that you are joking? This thing, two of us will die here. That was like what he was telling God. You will not tell person, don't even try. Because if you try, I will finish you. That's the way he was talking to God. He said, don't even try to tell me. You tell me, take them and go. And you will win. Amen. And when he said that, did God get angry?
God said to him, like what I told you is the one I told the bishop. You will remain here and I tell him, my Lord, no. He said, okay, don't worry, I will transfer you.
As soon as he said that to God, God said, what? Don't worry, I will go with you.
Amen. The Lord will go with you.
The Lord will be with you.
Amen.
Through this experience, in the last few days, God will forgive your sins. He will not remember your sins. He will do that which you are asking him for, and he will be with you. And when the Lord is with you, a lot of things will happen. You might not be rich like that today, but you will have inner joy. You will have inner peace. That's what Jesus said. I have told you that in the world you will not have what? Peace. But in me, you will have what? Peace. And with that, Moses had peace. He had confidence. He had trust. And when they went on that journey, they did not feel lonely again because the Shekinah glory was with them. Now, when that happened, when God gave that assurance to Moses, in verse 14, he said, my presence will go with you. I will go with you. And I will give you rest. Sometimes there is what is called holy doubt. Can you say it, everybody? Holy doubt. Holy what? Doubt. When God said, my presence, I will go with you. What's he said? Okay, I have heard you now. If you have agreed to go with me, then he said, let me see your dazzling world presence. Your dazzling glory. You remember what happened on Mount Tabor? When Jesus, when Elijah, when
Moses,
and then who? Is it Isaiah? Appeared to him on Mount Tabor. The glory of God was so powerful that Peter could not hold it anymore. He shouted, oh, how wonderful it is for us to be here. Lord, let us make three things. One for you, one for Moses, and one for what? Elijah. He did not remember himself that he would stay outside when they are inside the tent. He did not remember that dew would be falling on him. If you go up the mountain, you cannot stay outside the mountain for more than 5-10 minutes. You begin to shake with cold. Peter on the coat, the ordinary coat up there, because the glory of God was what? Awesome. I think that's where we got that song.
Awesome God, mighty God, we give you praise.
They moved with God. In fact, some persons were preaching.